As you can see, this curtain wall divides the curtain on left in a grid of 3x3 cells. We can customize these settings editing the curtain wall styles. So we will do right click on the curtain wall styles dialog in order to edit the existing curtain walls or creating new ones. So we're going to click on the new button, curtain wall style, and we're going to call this ground floor curtain wall. If we take a look at its components, we can see that we have a cell component that defines how the curtain wall is divided, a frame, and some mullions that define the profiles that divide the cells. So, for this particular curtain wall style, we're going to specify a cell division to horizontal division, which generates two sub-cell components. We will define the subdivision into fixed size, and for each cell we will define one particular size. We can set this to 0.7 and the other one to 2 meters. Now, at the same time, we can subdivide this cell component into different way. So we can set this to be divided into a fixed cell size, which dimensions would be 0.18 centimeters by 0.7, which is the dimension of this head, while the other one will be also divided into a fixed cell size of 0.18 by 2 meters. If you want to swap the position of each cell, you just need to click on this arrow to change it. We click OK, and now we can select these two curtain walls, go to Properties, and change it to the ground floor style we have just created. If we take a closer look at this style, we can see that the panels are not curved at all. So we can go back to the curtain wall styles dialog, and by selecting the ground floor, we can tell panels to be curved. If we click on the apply button, the whole curtain wall will get a smooth curved shape. Now, let's create a new style, but in this case for the main entrance. Actually, we can use the one that we have just created and modify it a little bit. Before this, we are going to change the frame dimensions, and we are going to set this width to 8 centimeters. Now, I do right click, I duplicate this style, and first of all, I'm going to change the position of the two cells, and instead of using a fixed cell size, I'm going to use a known division for the cell below, and a fixed number of cells for the cell above, which will be set to 2 vertical divisions and just 1 horizontal division. Finally, let's call this entrance style. Click OK. Existing curtain walls will update changes, and we finally select this curtain wall and define this new style we have created. Now we can insert a door to this main entrance and another door to that other curtain wall. So we run the door command, and working from the top viewport, we will switch layer where the ground floor bitmap is, and we will just select the hinged double style. Width would be defined by these values, and just click to the inner side of the curtain wall to define the opening direction. For the other door we have over here, we will select just a hinged one. The width would be something that go from this point to this point. And finally, selecting the opening direction.